we would say quite clearly that unless the company withdraw those preconditions, there is no hope whatsoever for any negotiations.
What about the risk of this spreading? In what way could this spread into the other CIEU companies, given that there is no dispute there?
Yeah, well, look, you hit the nail on the head. Look, we have no dispute with Irish Rail, or we have no dispute with Dublin Bus, and our members have been told that. But unfortunately, there are a number of shared locations in this country where Bus Éireann had depots that they share with Irish Rail. And our people have been telling us, in large numbers at this stage, that they're going to have extreme difficulty passing pickets at the depots next Monday. And that's a reality. It's unfortunate, but that's it. It's called a moral compass, and people understand when there's a picket on a gate that it's very difficult for any worker, certainly our members, to pass it.
What impact could that have on rail services?
Well, you'd have to be rocket science to understand that there's pickets on a gate and no one passes it in. Trains won't move from those locations, probably. But again, I'm at pace to point out, we're not officially in dispute with that employer.
What can the company do to make you happy here? They say they don't have any money. They're going to be broke. The minister says there's no more money for state subsidies. So, you know.
Well, Rory, lots of people are saying lots of things, but they're saying it remotely from where they should be saying it, which is around the table. And unless we get people around the table, and again, that stakeholder buy-in, there's going to be no resolution here.